my own silhouette. I'm getting stronger, step by step. The clock is ticking, but there's no time for regrets. I've been flying from town to town, from London to Taiwan. I've been all around the globe.
Doesn't look like much in the daylight, but I was pretty happy to see it last night. I'm heading for Ahike, I think. Not sure how that's pronounced. It's right on the lake. About 4.5 hours away through those mountains last night. Been winding down the side of the mountain on gravel, but now it looks like pavement. Some breakfast. That's a very nice group here from Los Angeles. They speak some English, so we had a little chit-chat. They're down visiting family here in San Marco. And 8 kilometers to go to Ahike. Fields of plants covered in white mask. Station I've ever had. It is 9:23 and I'm leaving Ahike and heading east. Google gave me an alternate route for a little bit off the highway. It certainly is off the highway, but pretty. Here I am an hour and a quarter after leaving and I'm back on the shore of the lake at the eastern side of it. My volcano right there. I'm now climbing the side of the mountain on a much smaller road. pheasant up here. Almost no one around. See down into the valley there. Windy little road climbing up the mountain. Lots of vegetation. This is definitely the most unpopulated area I've seen since hitting the mainland. There seems to be like ranches, but that's about it. The blocks the villagers have put up. I don't know if I'm going to get to the church, but it's certainly a nice ride. To the side of where the volcano is. So now I need to get turned around without doing anything stupid. Front brakes don't do squat. There we go. Here's the gate. I flew the drone and I saw the lava field, but it's quite a distance away and I started to lose contact with the drone, so doubt that I got very good footage, and I have no intention of climbing up that trail in this heat. But it was a nice ride up here. Now I gotta find a place to stay. Just resting here for a moment and looking at the clouds. Such a beautiful place. Look at how crisp those clouds are. I think it's actually raining over on that other mountain. But a very nice spot. Jungle-like. Quite nice. Still 30 degrees, but every now and then you get some shade. Great at reaching goals today, but it's been fabulous riding. Really enjoying it. Temperature is like 24 degrees up at the peak of this mountain, volcano, whatever it is. now descending down the other side. These trees are everywhere right now. They're pretty spectacular. It is 8:41 in the morning. And I'm a little delayed because this place has internet, so I posted a video because the next place does not. But it's been a very nice little town. The roundabouts aren't nearly so scary this time of the morning. Well, that was an experience. No huevos. Had some sort of pork. Tacos. They were tasty. The landscape here seems to have dried out considerably. There's a big lake right over there. But it's also, I think, much cooler. This is why I decided not to go into Mexico City. Morelia's not that big. The traffic is just horrendous. And, you know, you're broiling away out here on your little motorcycle. I just don't even know what that is.
Coffee? It's very hard to find good coffee. Pastries, snacks.
Orange juice.
I'll have orange juice and a coffee.
And enjoy. Nescafe.
And
orange juice and coffee.
Yeah, and that creamer stuff, that you get to pick up.
That was a very enjoyable coffee and fresh orange juice sitting by the lake. Well, that was very nice. Fresh pineapple juice. And this very nice little sidebar. Volcanoes everywhere. Pass, except for these local buses, which know the roads incredibly well and travel them at unbelievable speed. The trick is to catch them on an upward corner. But yeah, they really move. Google's traffic advice does not seem to be very accurate here. I don't know why, but like it's showing red here. And there's nothing. It's happened a few times. Maybe not very many people use Google down here. There is a castle out here in the middle of nowhere. And it's raining. For the very first time since San Francisco. This is the main road into Valle de Bravo. Very windy, lots of traffic.
And lots of restaurants.
Yeah, restaurant. This restaurant.
It's already
good. Eh?
Oh, what kind of food?
Soup.
Gracias. Okay, I'll be back later. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So it's kind of a hostel slash hotel. I only booked the one night because booking.com said it didn't have Wi-Fi or anywhere to park, but there's Wi-Fi right over my door. And they said I can bring the bike in to the office at night, just pretty sweet. So it's on the second floor. And then there's a rooftop, which I haven't seen yet. That's my room right there, Bravo, which is a beautiful town. Very plain, but clean. And rooftop.
This guy, Louis, showed up and saw my bike and asked if he could meet me. And Eduardo came to get me and we chatted. He lives here, but he rides an Africa Twin. And I mentioned that I was going to the volcano. And he's like, oh, I'll come with you. And so I have a new riding buddy for the day, which is kind of fun. Oh, really? I'm gonna need to throw on a layer. Oh, okay. Okay. Good, good.
Show any fear. I've been flying from town to town.
They don't allow cars inside the park here. Only bicycles, motorcycles, walking, or you can get in one of these pickup trucks. Taco stands just at the entrance to the park. Oh, Matilda, you get to get out.
This one.
I know. This is the mushroom soup.
Mushrooms with like vegetables.
So good. And these are
tacos. This is from adobado. And the other one is flor de calabaza.
Oh, you're so smart, Matilda. I keep talking about the temperature, but it's now 39 degrees, which is really uncomfortably hot.
Oh, I found a place for the night.
There's a shared bathroom, 700 pesos.